In the last century, we've learned that the universe behaves differently than we expected and is made of stuff that we never expected.
So often, an exhibit or a show, particularly at a museum, celebrates what we know. And you expect that. Here's what we know. But how about the stuff we don't know? That excites me. So for our fifth space show of the Hayden Planetarium at the Rose Center for Earth and Space, this is a show that, in a way, celebrates the unknown.
Since the last space show opened in 2009, perhaps the biggest themes in cosmology have been pushing to ultimately measure the properties of dark energy and zeroing in on just what the heck dark matter is. Many people don't know that the museum is also a major research institute. Included in our astrophysics research program is work directly related to the topic of this show, taking data from the Hubble telescope and using it to identify distant supernovae, and from that to help measure the properties of dark energy. This space show is not just about what the universe is, but how we measure it.
We have filmed two observatories, Mount Wilson in California, where the expanding universe was discovered. We also filmed at the former Bell Labs in New Jersey, where the microwave antenna was able to detect this background radiation predicted by the theory of the Big Bang. Going to an instrument like that is really exciting. It's exciting to bring it to our public.
We're pulling out all the stops, creating a visual and intellectual spectacle. Once you understand something that was once a mystery, you have a new place to stand, a new place to look, a new vista upon which to drink in all that you don't yet know about the universe. And so, really, science is about revealing places to stand that you didn't even previously know existed. Therein are the deepest discoveries we can make.
I think we've been reaching always for a description of how we fit into this big picture. We've done that sitting around the campfire telling stories. We've done that by building space programs. We do that by building fantastic instruments on top of mountains where they can see, and putting instruments in orbit. And that grandness of figuring out these vast timescales and spatial scales is what makes us uniquely human. We have always been reaching for that understanding, and that's what coming to the planetarium should be about.